This is Rex Gatto. I'm a business psychologist as well as a board certified coach. And I would like to share with you why there is such a tremendous need for physician coaching. Some facts about physicians, and then we'll get into what coaching is. And then I'll give you some tools or share some tools with you that you would be able to help a colleague. We know that the burnout rates, geographical location experience, specialty, age, and gender do impact, but we know roughly 50% of the physicians today have experienced or are experiencing burnout. Burnout rates are higher among physicians who are on that front line, family practice, emergency medicine, trauma, surgeries, orthopedic and neuro, as well as hospitalists. And hospitalists today are really dealing with the COVID outbreak, but then all physicians are dealing with the COVID outbreak, and this has caused even a higher level of stress within the workplace. What is burnout? Burnout is workplace stress, and it can be classified in the ICD, International Classification for Disease, or the DSM, Diagnostic Statistical Manual, which psychologists or psychiatrists use. If you see a client or peer, APP, advanced practice provider, PA, or nurses experiencing emotional exhaustion or negativity toward their career, a lack of productivity, or an inability to concentrate, say something. They probably are experiencing burnout, anxiety, depressed mood, and you might even see that through a lack of concentration. So work has to be redone. I've even noted working with a physician recently who just did not want to complete the medical record, and it kept piling up and piling up, and now he is a month behind. So burnout is a negative association with altruism in my profession. Why did I get into medicine? Why? I don't feel fulfilled. I don't feel safe anymore. So there is this association of negativity toward the workplace. And we know through higher levels of stress and anxiety, the cardiovascular disease can manifest itself, as well as addiction. And we are seeing higher levels of addiction and depressed mood, as I mentioned. And one of the saddest aspects is the suicide rate among physicians is increasing. What's the difference between male and female? The female physician is more likely to demonstrate a dissatisfaction within the workplace, total emotional exhaustion, even asking for sick leave. Females are more likely to express their dissatisfaction. Males will hold in their dissatisfaction, and it will manifest itself through a depersonalization or a detachment or a disengagement or I just don't care attitude. You may notice that. Why are female physicians more burned out than male physicians? Number one reason is childcare and then care for the house. Females still are the caregivers for the children and the house. This is a generalized statement. There are exceptions, but more often than not, the female is in charge and the female physician takes more on. Specializing in a medical practice that they may not make as much money is also an issue that's documented in the research, and even some aspects of discrimination around surgery and being held back from not going into more lucrative practices. An interesting fact was that appointments with female physicians are 10% longer, and that is because patients will share more with a female physician. What are the reasons to implement a coaching process? I mentioned burnout. Let me mention a few other aspects. One is if you see somebody who has a great deal of talent and could be a chief, work with them. Help them to be a medical leader. Someone who needs the experience of someone who has been in a practice for a while. Maybe you could slow down and share with them some of your experiences and how you dealt with things as a junior faculty. Also, partnering coaching can give you a strategic or competitive edge. This can also help to create a succession plan within the hospital or practice, and then the retention of the right people. What is a coaching process? I want to go through this briefly, and then I will help to give some tools that I use that you can immediately use with a colleague if you see them in a depressed mood or in any of those other aspects of burnout that I referred to. Coaching is a partnership, and the idea of coaching is really focused on goals. And it's working with someone who is focused on and cooperative on achieving key goals, personal as well as professional. Personal growth, professional growth. It is to help them to have a better quality of life. Coaching is generally one-on-one. There are exceptions to that, but generally, it is a one-on-one experience, working with someone who wants to develop their skills. This gives an opportunity for someone to develop an enhanced work plan for themselves, to feel engaged again within the workplace and career. Remember, what you reward people will do, and they will take a look at what is rewarded in your workplace culture. I want to talk about the types of goals. Performance goals are meeting the objectives or measuring performance. That's what happens each year when you get a performance feedback. Learning goals are learning the how-tos, better dealing with patients, or being able to navigate within the hospital system or practice. Learning the how-tos, as well as medical policy and procedures, to navigating within a culture. Fulfillment is building relationships, feeling fulfilled within the workplace, doing research, gaining colleagues, peers, helping people to find a better quality of life. So there are three types of goals, then performance goals, learning goals, and fulfillment goals. You can look at these and see for yourself, and if you are coaching or helping someone else, the types of goals that would benefit them. What are some of the coaching tools? First and foremost, goals. Take a look on the top left-hand side. Goals or desired outcomes that you want. And on the right-hand side, how things are progressing to meeting those goals or outcomes. Below are the actions, sustainable actions, sustainable change. And below that, what is a personal affirmation of success? Why do you feel you are successful? What is it that drives you, and why are you successful? Another tool that I use is energizers in the workplace and drainers. I have people outline what gives you the buzz at work, what drains you at work, what takes away from you at work. And then below, your personal affirmation. I am successful because. Don't walk out of work every day thinking, what didn't I get to? Walk out of work thinking the patients that you helped and supported, colleagues that you supported, the work that you completed, success in moving and advancing, the fulfillment of your own careers, personal affirmation. Focus on those energizers. Talk about the drainers with a colleague, and I bet you'll find out that you're not the only one that feels that way. Another question about motivation. I like to ask this when I'm working one-on-one. Your very first year of residency, what motivated you? Now that you are an attending, what motivates you now? And what would motivate you to coach or to help others through peer coaching? Jot those down. Don't keep them up in your head. You notice that I have visual journals. Now, I pause there because I want to make the difference rather than thinking about it, which causes rumination. Jot things down. Get a file. put it in your computer, put information in there so that it's measurable, get it up and out of your head and on to a realistic, tangible thought. Make sure there that you can see it. So summarizing your thoughts, what is it that you want to learn about yourself? What is it that you want to learn about yourself? That's a great question, not only for you to ask yourself, but to ask somebody that you're coaching. What do you want to learn about yourself? There are always alternatives. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, everyone has a story. Everyone. Question, are you the best version of you? I have three questions for you. What do you think you want for yourself? What is it that you want for yourself? Second question, what do you think patients want from a medical provider? And the third question, what do you think people at either the hospital or practice want from you? You ought to reflect on those three key points. Ladies and gentlemen, if you would like to explore concepts of coaching, all you need to do is give me a call or send me an email. I would be very happy to share with you aspects of coaching. There are many, many tools that are out there, but I could take 2 hours to go through all the tools and assessments that I use in coaching. I just wanted to give you enough information to help colleagues if you see them experiencing burnout, or if you're experiencing burnout. Please say something, talk with somebody, help somebody through a coaching process. Best of luck.